وتعاونوا على البر والتقوى ولا تعاونوا على الإثم والعدوان واتقوا الله إن الله شديد العقاب.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، ما يهده الله فلا مضل له وما يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وأصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين. We welcome our brothers and sisters to our last lecture tonight. And alhamdulillah, we have the honor of hosting our next noble guest and speaker, Abu Husam Muhannad Ar-Ramli. And our brother, he will be enlightening us on the pertinent and extremely important topic entitled Kind Words and Good Manners. As for those who are about to hear him for the first time, then Abu Husam presently lives in the community of Sheikh Abdul Rahman Al-Umaysan, who himself will be delivering his lecture tomorrow, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, as part of this three-day conference. So our brother Muhannad has been translating the Sheikh's weekly sermons, durus, and lectures, alhamdulillah, in Hamtramck, Michigan. And he is someone who is well known and recommended by the Sheikh. The Sheikh, he has known Muhannad for a long time, I think, from what I remember, 15 years. And I also heard that the Sheikh recommended Muhannad as one of the brothers by which the brothers and sisters should try to benefit from. We ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make his presence beneficial. And I delayed, I should have given the brother salam. Salamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Muhannad, ahlan bik. Alhamdulillah. It's a pleasure to have you with us on our platform, alhamdulillah. We're honored to have you here and to be a part of this conference. So without any further delay, I'm not going to take up too much more of your time. Fatafaddal.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu, nasta'inuhu, nastaghfiruhu, na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyi'ati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu. Sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ما بعد. It pleases me to be with my brothers and and it is an honor to be amongst my brothers and sisters in this seminar, in this series of lectures, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his names and attributes to make the efforts of my brothers at Masjid Tawheed in Trinidad to make all of their efforts in their records of good deeds. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give all of us sincerity in all of our actions and speech and in everything we do. And as you heard, the lecture, the topic of the lecture will be about good words and about good manners, kind words and good manners. There's no doubt, my brothers and sisters, my noble brothers and sisters, that this religion of ours, the religion of Islam, is a religion that calls us to everything that is good. There's nothing we find in the legislation of Islam except that is good for us, except that is good. and it warns us against everything that is evil. And from that which our religion, calls us to, is to have good manners, is to speak good words and have good manners. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. Indeed, I was sent to complete and perfect the good manners. And we find that good manners are in everything in our religion. If we look at anything in our religion, we find that it has good manners and it calls us to good manners. Starting from the five pillars of Islam, we find good manners in the five pillars of Islam. An example of this is, the first of all, is Tawheedullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first of the five pillars of Islam, to testify that there's none worthy of worship except Allah and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. We find in this is the good manner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone with no partners. And for this reason, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, what is the most severe of all sins? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he answered by saying, أَن تَجْعَلَ لِلَّهِ نِدًّا وَهُوَ خَلَقَكَ. He reminded us that from the good manner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to remember that He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created us. That He is the one who created us, and therefore it is upon us to single Him out, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is from the manners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we associate none with Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And likewise, in the testimony to testify that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, we find that it includes honoring and respecting the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam during his life and after his death, and to honor and respect his words and to take his words and consider them to be a guideline for us in our lives. This is from the manners towards the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if we read Surah Al-Hujurat, we find a great deal of commands from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us in regards to respecting the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in regards to how we are supposed to be with the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also with each other. So this is in the two testimonies. Likewise, in the prayer, the second pillar of the pillars of Islam, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about the prayer, what means indeed the prayer prohibits immorality and wrongdoing. We find in the salah that it corrects one's manners and it corrects one's it removes the wrongdoings and the immorality. And also, when it comes to the zakat, the specific zakat and the sadaqat in general, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in regards to all of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded us of the good manners when it comes to the zakat and to the sadaqat in general, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَىٰ كَالَّذِي يُنْفِقُ مَالَهُ رِئَاءَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ صَفْوَانٍ عَلَيْهِ تُرَابٌ فَأَصَابَهُ وَابِلٌ فَتَرَكَهُ صَلْدًا لَا يَقْدِرُونَ عَلَىٰ شَيْءٍ مِمَّا كَسَبُوا وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the meaning of the verse, O you who believe, do not invalidate your charities with reminders or injury as one does who spends his wealth only to be seen by the people and does not believe in Allah on the last day. And so on with the pillars of Islam. In all of the pillars of Islam, we find that it corrects one's manners. The fasting, in which the person remembers the patience upon the hardships, also remembers the needy and the hungry, and he feels what they feel. In all of that is a remembrance, and in all of that is the good manners. Similarly, with performing Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade us from anything that invalidates or removes some of the reward of our Hajj, from the likes of even debates, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade us from debating when performing Hajj, or speaking with harshness or anything of the sort. So all of that is, we find in all of the pillars of Islam, a call and a reminder to having good manners. To having good manners and proper character, and from the most important of the manners is the speech, is one's words, the choice of words, what words the person chooses, and how he speaks to the people. This is something of great importance. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as in the hadith, that is reported, that is agreed upon by Al-Bukhari and Muslim, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, as in the hadith that is agreed upon, one who believes in Allah and the last day, let him say good words, let him say good things, or remain silent. And similarly, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as in the hadith that is graded authentic by Imam al-Albani rahimahullah, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ لَيَتَكَلَّمُ بِالْكَلِمَةِ مِنْ رُضْوَانِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. One of you speaks the word from the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him. مَا يَظُنُّ أَن تَبْلُغَ مَا بَلَغَتْ. He does not think that it will reach that which it has reached. فَيَكْتُبُ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِهَا رِضْوَانَهُ إِلَى يَوْمِ يَلْقَاهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write for him that he is pleased with him until the day he meets him. وَإِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ لَيَتَكَلَّمُ بِالْكَلِمَةِ مِنْ سَخَطِ اللَّهِ. مَا يَظُنُّ أَن تَبْلُغَ مَا تَبْلُغُ. One of you speaks the word from the anger of Allah upon him. He does not think that it will reach that which it reaches. فَيَكْتُبُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ بِهَا سَخَطَهُ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah will write for him his anger because of it until the day he meets him. وَهَذَا يَا إِخْوَةِ. And all of this, we find it today. And we find the reality of all of this today, where a person can speak a word, and through social media and what we have, and inshallah, tomorrow's lecture by our noble Sheikh, Sheikh Abdurrahman Al-Maisan, will be about social media and improper use of social media. But nevertheless, we find that a person could speak a word that goes all across the world, that people hear it all over the world. So if it is a good word, people will hear this good word. And if it's an evil word, if it's a word that brings forth the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so many people will hear it and so many people will send it. So we have to be careful with the words that we choose and the speech that we utter with. Likewise, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was asked by Mu'adh bin Jabal, may Allah be pleased with him, he asked him, are we judged for the words that we say, for the things we speak? And the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked him and he said to him, what throws the people in the hellfire on their faces except the collection of what their tongues utter and what their tongues say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to speak good words, where he subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ husna, and say to the people good words. And likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us the example of a good word, where he subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا كَلِمَةً طَيِّبَةً كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةً أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ وَفَرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ تُؤْتِي أُكُلَهَا كُلَّ حِينٍ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهَا وَيَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالَ لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ وَمَثَلُ كَلِمَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ كَشَجَرَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ اجْتُثَّتْ مِنْ فَوْقِ الْأَرْضِ مَا لَهَا مِنْ قَرَارٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the example of a good word, the word of tawheed first and foremost, the word of la ilaha illallah first and foremost, and then the rest of the good words. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, have you not considered how Allah presents an example, making a good word like a good tree whose root is firmly fixed and its branches are high in the sky. It produces its fruit all the time by the permission of its Lord. And Allah presents examples for the people that perhaps they will be reminded. And the example of a bad word is like a bad tree, uprooted from the surface of earth, not having any stability. One of the tabi'een, al-imam Yahya bin Mu'adh rahimahullah, he said, al-qulubu kal-qudur taghli bima fiha. And listen to this excellent example. He rahimahullah, he said, the hearts are like utensils, or are like pots that boil with what's inside them. وَأَلْسِنَتُهَا مَصَارِفُهَا. And the tongues are the places from which the liquid escapes. And this is an excellent example. فَانْظُرْ إِلَى الرَّجُلِ حِينَ يَتَكَلَّمْ. He said, look at the man when he speaks. فَإِنَّ لِسَانَهُ يَغْتَرِفُ لَكَ مِمَّا فِي قَلْبِهِ. His tongue brings out what's on his heart, what's in his heart. So you find what's in a person's heart on his tongue. So we have to be careful with our words. We need to know that our words represent what's in our hearts. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as in the hadith that is graded strong, Hassan by Imam al-Albani rahimahullah that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, إذا أصبح ابن آدم فإن الأعضاء كلها تكفر اللسان فتقول اتق الله فينا فإنما نحن بك فإن استقمت استقمنا وإن عوججت عوججنا. When the person wakes up in the morning, all of his limbs will say to his tongue, fear Allah with us. Fear Allah in regards to us, because we are connected with you. If you are upright and if you are rectified and are upright, then we all will be upright and will be rectified. And if you are twisted, we all will be twisted. An example of evil speech which brings the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is spreading rumors. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam one time passed by the graves of two men. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, those two men are being punished. And he mentioned they are not punished for something that the people consider to be something that is major. But indeed, it is something that is major. As for, he sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he mentioned one of them used to spread rumors, used to spread gossip and rumors between the people. And this, without a doubt, is a great and is a major sin, because it causes spreading rumors and gossip between the people, causes enmity between the brothers. It causes hatred and enmity between the brothers. So it's such a great and dangerous sin because of that. So one must watch what his tongue utters and what he says. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَهُمْ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ كَانَ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لِلْإِنسَانِ عَدُوًا مُبِينًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that the shaytan is our enemy. It is upon us to take the shaytan as an enemy. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to us, أَلَمْ أَعْهَدْ إِلَيْكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدَمَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا الشَّيْطَانِ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوًا مُبِينًا. Did I not inform you and command you, O son of Adam, not to take the shaytan, to worship the shaytan? Indeed, he is to you a clear enemy. And in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that I just mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ, and say to my servants to say that which is best. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَهُمْ. So we need to be careful with what we utter. The shaytan tries to cause enmity and hatred between the people. We need to understand, indeed, the shaytan to mankind is a clear enemy. We need to understand that the shaytan wants us to have this enmity, to have hatred towards another. The shaytan encourages us to say words that cause enmity and hatred between the brothers, from the likes of, have you seen what so-and-so had said about you? Have you seen, and this is from the namima, that is impermissible, that is from the major sins, spreading rumors and causing enmity between the people and between the brothers. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا, and say to the people good words. Speak to the people with good words. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that most of the speech that the people speak between one another is of no good. As he subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَا خَيْرَ فِي كَثِيرٍ مِّن نَجْوَاهُمْ إِلَّا مَنْ أَمَرَ بِصَدَقَةٍ أَوْ مَعْرُوفٍ أَوْ إِصْلَاحٍ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ بَتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ فَسَوْفَ نُؤْتِيهِ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. There's no good in most of their secret speech, except the one who commands and who enjoys the sadaqah, the charity, and doing good and rectification between and reconciling between the people. And whomsoever does so, seeking the pleasure of Allah, then we will give him a great reward. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what means, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا يحب الله الجهر بالسوء من القول إلا من ظلم وكان الله سميعا عليما. Allah does not like the public mention of evil except by one who has been wronged. My dear brothers and sisters, it is upon us to understand that and to know that the good word is something that brings the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us with, to say good words to each other, to speak with kindness to one another. Even if one speaks to you harshly, then reply with good words. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيَّاءِ اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ, فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم وما يلقاها إلا الذين كما أخبرنا الله سبحانه وتعالى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us and reminded us that they are not the evil words, the hasana, the good things, and the evil are not equal. So bring forth that which is good, and it causes the one that you have an enmity between you and him to become like a close beloved friend. And this is for no one except those who are pious, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, عَلَى كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ صَدَقَةً. There's a charity upon every Muslim. He was asked, فَإِنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ. If one cannot afford it, he sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, فَلْيَعْمَلْ بِيَدِهِ فَلْيَنْفَعْ نَفْسَهُ وَيَتَصَدَّقْ. Let him work, and he will benefit, and he will give in charities. And قَالُوا فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ. أو لم يفعل. What if he wasn't able to? قال فيعين ذا الحاجة الملهوف. Let him help the one who needs help, who needs assistance. قالوا فإن لم يفعل. He was asked, what if he wasn't able to? قال فليأمر بالمعروف. قالوا فإن لم يفعل. So he said, let him enjoy the good. What if he cannot? Then the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, فليمسك عن الشر. يعني هذا أقل الأحوال, أن يمسك الإنسان عن الشر, أن لا يتكلم بالشر, أن لا ينشر الكلام الذي يفسد بين الإخوة. To let him withhold from everything that is evil. This is the least that the person can do, to withhold. Not to say the things that cause enmity, that cause hatred between the brothers. قال فإنه له صدقة. Doing so, withholding from speaking evil words, is a charity. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, protect yourselves from the hellfire even if it was half a date fruit. قال فمن لم يجد فبكلمة طيبة. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, if he cannot find not even half a date fruit, then let it be with a good word. Why? Because the good word is a charity. As he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, speaking good words is a charity. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أيضا فيما يتعلق بمكارم الأخلاق وبالأخلاق الطيبة. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned in regards to good manners. He said, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. Do not belittle anything of doing good to others. ولو أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طلق. Even if it was to meet your brother with a good smile, with a pleasant look. And the hadith is reported by Muslim. And also, Umar رضي الله عنه, he said, البر شيء هين وجه طليق وكلام لين. May Allah be pleased with him, Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him, he said, righteousness is something that is easy. It is a pleasant face, a happy, a smiley face, and soft speech. Abu al-Muqdad reported on behalf of his father, on behalf of his grandfather, that the messenger that he asked the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he asked, أخبرني بشيء يوجب الجنة. He asked the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, tell me of something, inform me of something that will make me enter the paradise. And the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, عليك بحسن الكلام وبذل الطعام. Upon you is to speak good words and to feed the people. And the hadith is graded authentic by Imam al-Albani rahimahullah. And from the good speech and the good manners is that the person does not go into argumentation and debate except with that which is best. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us and said, أنا زعيم ببيت في ربض الجنة لمن ترك المراء وهو محق وببيت في وسط الجنة لمن ترك الكذب وإن كان مازحا وفي بيت وببيت في أعلى الجنة لمن حسن خلقه. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, I guarantee a house in the lowest of the paradise for the one who leaves off debates, even if he was truthful, even if he was right, even if he was upon right to leave off debating. And a house in the middle of the Jannah to the one who leaves off lying, even if it was joking. And in a house in the highest of the paradise for the one who has good manners. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to take the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam as an example, to follow his footsteps and take him as an example. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر. To you is an excellent example in the Messenger of Allah for the one who hopes to meet Allah in the last day, and for the one who believes in Allah in the last day. To take the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam as an example. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likewise told us about the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, addressing him, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are upon great manner. For the one who wants to follow the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is upon him to read and study the Sunnah and the way of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and see his manners and see how he was. From the great manners that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam was upon is the manner of patience. Being patient, when Aisha radiallahu anha reported that some of the Jews came to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they would say, Assalamu alayka. Assalamu alayka means death upon you. But the word, of course, as you hear, the word in Arabic sounds similar to Assalamu alayka. So they wanted to say it in a way that sounds like they're greeting him, but in reality they are saying death is upon you. Assalamu alayka. May death be upon you. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would reply by saying, Wa alaykum, and upon you. Aisha radiallahu anha, she heard them and she said, Wa alaykum assam wal la'na, and upon you death and the curse of Allah. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told her and he said to her, No, be kind. And Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, Didn't you hear what they said? And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, And I said, Wa alaykum. Didn't you hear what I said? Wa alaykum, and upon you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, like we said, that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, addressing him, "Wa innaka la'ala khuluqin 'azim," and indeed you are upon a great manner. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma kana ahadun ahsana khuluqan min Aisha radiyallahu anha qalat, ma kana ahadun ahsana khuluqan min Rasulillah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ma da'ahu ahadun min ashabihi wala min ahli baytihi illa qala labbayk." فَلِذَلِكَ أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and indeed you are upon great manner, because no one would call him except the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say labbaik. يعني I listen to you, I'm listening to you, I'm with you, as they say. The word labbaik, it means I am with you. You tell me what you want. It comes in that meaning. And so the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to be kind to all of the people. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Khayrukum khayrukum li ahli, wa ana khayrukum li ahli." It is unfortunate, my brother, my noble brothers and sisters, that some people, they are very kind and very good to the people, but when it is in their own houses, in their own homes, they are like monsters. Their own family and their wives or their spouses and their children, they fear them, they are afraid of them, and this is not proper. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was kind first and foremost to his family. Khayrukum khayrukum li ahli, the best of you are the best of you towards their families. Wa ana khayrukum li ahli, and I am the best of you towards my family. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said ahabbu ibadillahi ila Allah ahsanuhum akhlaqa, the most beloved of the servants of Allah to Allah are the ones the best in manners. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم إن من أحبكم إلي وأقربكم مني مجلسا يوم القيامة أحاسنكم أخلاقا. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, the most beloved to me and the nearest to me in their position in the on the day of judgment are the best from amongst you in their manners. And the hadith is graded Hassan, strong and good, by Imam al-Albani رحمه الله. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من شيء في الميزان أثقل من حسن الخلق. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, there is nothing that is heavier in the scale on the day of judgment than the good manners. And the hadith is graded authentic by Imam al-Albani. And likewise, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن الرجل لا يدرك درجة الصائم القائم بحسن الخلق. الصائم في النهار القائم في الليل الذي يصوم نهاره ويقوم نومه ويقوم ليله الذي يحسن خلقه يصل إلى درجة هذا. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم told us that the one who has good manners, he reaches the level of the one who fasts the days and prays night prayers during the nights, just by having good manners. And this is from the mercy and the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also from the goodness and from the virtue of good manners is that they increase one's life. They increase one's life and they establish his home, as he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his dwelling, as he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حُسْنُ الْخُلُقْ وَحُسْنُ الْجِوَارِ يَعْمُرَانِ الْدِيَارِ وَيَزِيدَانِ فِي الْأَعْمَارِ. Having good, being a good neighbor and having good manners, they build one's dwelling and one's home and they increase one's life. And the hadith is graded authentic by Imam al-Albani rahimahullah. And likewise, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the best, the most from the believers in belief are the best in manners. And the hadith in regards to having good manners are many. And there are many, all of the good manners are things that our religion of Islam has called us to. From that is, as we mentioned, kindness and mercy. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna al-rifqa la yakunu fi shay'in illa zana, wa la yunza'u min shay'in illa shana." Kindness and mercy are not found in anything that except that they beautify it, and they are not removed from anything except that they make it ugly. Also, from the good manners and from the kindness and mercy is kindness and mercy towards the animals. Towards the animals. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us of a prostitute from those who were before us that she entered the paradise because of giving water to a thirsty dog. And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was kind to animals, and also he sallallahu alaihi wasallam was kind to objects. He was kind and had mercy towards objects. When he sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the minbar was built for him, the trunk of the tree that where he used to stand started crying, and the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, out of his kindness and mercy, that he came and he put his hand on it so it would stop crying. And he sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, had I not done that, you would continue to hear it crying until the day of judgment. So we find also from the good manners is wanting good for others. Wanting good for others. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned that one of you does not believe until he loves for his brother that which he loves for himself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the description of the believers, وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةً, that they make others proceed and they give them and they hope for them more than they wish for them, more than they wish for themselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about the believers and the companions, may Allah be pleased with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لولا, when the rumors, the false rumors were spread against Aisha radiallahu anha, our mother, the mother of the believers, Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, when those false rumors were spreading against her, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about their statement, لولا إذ سمعتموه ظن المؤمنون والمؤمنات بأنفسهم خيرا وقالوا هذا إفك مبين. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى ظن المؤمنون والمؤمنات بأنفسهم خيرا. ذكر أهل العلم وأهل التفسير كالإمام السعدي رحمه الله وغيره المقصود أنهم ظن أحدهم يعني ظن المؤمنون بعضهم ببعض خيرا، ولكن الله سبحانه وتعالى جعل ظن الإنسان بأخيه كأنه يظن بنفسه، ظن المؤمنون والمؤمنات بأنفسهم خيرا، أي ظن بأنفسهم هم، لأن ما تظنه عن أخيك كأنك تظن نفسك عليه أو تظنه على نفسك. الله سبحانه وتعالى told us, like we mentioned in regards to the false accusations that were made against our mother Aisha رضي الله عنها, had they heard it, the believing men and believing women thought good of themselves, and they said, indeed this is a clear lie. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that they thought good of themselves. The people of tafsir, the scholars of tafsir, the scholars who explained those verses from the Quran, they said that the meaning is that they thought good of each other. The believing men and women, they thought good of each other. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned it and used the word they thought good of themselves. Why? Because if one, what you think of your brother is like what you think of yourself, of your own self. And also from the good manners that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us with is justice. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. Indeed, Allah commands you with justice and doing good. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَقْصِطُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْصِطِينَ. And be just. Allah loves those who are just. وَقَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَإِذَا قُلْتُمْ فَاعْدِلُوا وَلَوْ كَانَ ذَا قُرْبَى. يعني ولو كان من تتكلمون عنه لو كان الموضوع يتعلق والكلام يتعلق بذي القربة فلا بد من أن يعدل الإنسان في كلامه. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى said to us, and if you speak, then be just, even if it was a close relative. So it is upon us to be just in our speech, even when we speak in regards to matters that concern our families and our relatives. And similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us and commanded us to be just, even in regards to our enemies. If we have an enemy, to be just towards our enemies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ لِلَّهِ شُهَدَاءَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. O you who believe, be stand up for Allah, be witnesses with the truth, with the justice, and do not allow your enmity towards a people that you are not just. Be just, it is closer to piety, and fear Allah. Indeed, Allah knows and is acquainted with all that you do. My dear brothers and sisters, the good manners that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us with, and this religion of ours, the religion of Islam, orders us with, are many. Every good manner that we find that our religion calls us to. And it is impossible to collect all of them, or even cover this topic with its due right in a single lecture. This is a topic that the people of knowledge have written books upon and have series of lectures in regards to having good manners. So we just wanted to touch upon the subject and to remind ourselves and all of our brothers of the importance of having good manners. And this is more so in regards to giving da'wah, when calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is very important for the one who wants to call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have good manners. Some of the people of knowledge, they mention Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, as far as I remember, in his explanation on Hilya Talib al-Ilm, the etiquette of the student of knowledge. And it might be someone else, but as far as I remember that he mentioned, he said that the student of knowledge, the student of knowledge is like a bottle, and the knowledge is like the water that you pour in this bottle. And if the bottle had a hole in it, this water surely will come out. Regardless how much you try to fill it, it will become empty. The water is going to come out of it. And similarly, This hole is like having bad manners. If the student of knowledge doesn't have the good manners, the knowledge that he has will surely go away. Also, another example, barakallahu fikum, my dear brothers and sisters, another example is a bottle of water, again, that is clear and pure and good water. You give it to someone who's thirsty, is going to take it and will be happy with it. Take the same bottle and put it in mud and try to give it to the person. Try to present it to someone and say, this is good, clean, good water. He's not going to like it. And this is so in regards to the students of knowledge. If you don't have the good manners, they will not accept, even if what you're trying to call them to is good. Even if you're calling them to good things, you're calling them to that which is good and forbidding the evil. The people will see that this bottle has dirt on it, has mud on it. They will not like it. They will not accept it from you. And likewise, if you try to call them and you don't have the good manners, they will not accept your call. They will not listen to you. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah, he said, how many people call people to good and at the same time, they make them run away from the good they are calling them to? Why? Because they don't have the proper way. They don't have the good manners. So we conclude by, first of all, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give all of us good manners and to keep us upright upon his religion. And I conclude by thanking my noble brothers in Masjid al-Tawheed in Trinidad and all of the brothers and sisters listening in. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of their efforts of my brothers in Masjid al-Tawheed in Trinidad, to make all of their efforts and their records of good deeds and to increase all of us in goodness. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد
وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. آمين. جزاك الله خيرا أخ مهند.
وجزاكم بارك الله فيكم.
These words was indeed a beneficial reminder for all of us, and it is indeed an extremely important topic, especially the last part that you mentioned. It really hit the heart, and that is the akhlaq and the manners with which the student needs to thread upon in order for his da'wah to be accepted. Many of us, you know, we fall short in that particular affair, and like you rightly supplicated, we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make us from those that understand the importance in giving da'wah and having good manners at the same time. And that example of the water, the bottle of water in the mud, no one is going to accept it. Even the water inside, if you look at it from a different angle, even if the water inside of the bottle is pure, but the outside is muddy, who's going to really accept it? No one wants to accept that water and drink it. So, barakallahu feek. We ask Allah to barakallahu ta'ala. Ameen, ameen. Jazakallah khair. Wa feeka barakallah. We ask Allah to barakallahu ta'ala to put this tremendous reminder on your scale of good deeds, make it heavy on the day of standing and reckoning. With that, my noble believing brothers and sisters, and Muhannad, again, it is a pleasure to have you. Before we close, I just want to inform all of our brothers and sisters that we have the pleasure of hosting Abu Hussam again tomorrow, as he's going to be translating our Sheikh Abdurrahman Al-Umaysan, whose talk is going to be roughly after Maghrib here in Trinidad, which is 6:20, 6:30 p.m., bidhinillahi ta'ala. So our brother will be doing the live translation, as he is the one who translates presently for the Sheikh in Hamtramck. With that mind, well, beloved brothers and sisters, today was a tremendous day. Alhamdulillah, we benefited from all of these tawjihats, all of these directions and reminders. We had the honor of our Sheikh opening the program, Sheikh Ali bin Yahya al-Haddadi, Hafidhahullah. And then we were given the honor with our brother, Abu Abdussalam Siddiq al-Jayani, and now tonight with our brother Abu Hussam Muhannad al-Ramli. We ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to accept from all of us and to put all of their efforts, make it heavy on their scales, and to make us from those who continue trying to strive hard to benefit from this vast knowledge which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gives to whomsoever He pleases. We ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to give us all a good ending. May Allah bless all of you and protect all of you. Remember, we continue tomorrow, bidhnillahi ta'ala, from 1:30 p.m. with our brother Muhammad Abdul Wali. So we have four lectures tomorrow, bidnillah, and then Abu Yusuf Khalifa is going to be on at 4:30, and then we have Sheikh Abdul Rahman Al Umaysan at 6:20, and then we have the brother Abu Ilyas, who is going to be giving the last talk at 9 p.m. similar to tonight. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel and to click the bell icon so that you will be updated or you will know when we go on live. And with that, we call tonight, we give an end to our day of lectures. Barakallahu feekum wa subhanak Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.